This is Chris. Yesterday, I was watching a video by Steve from Flipside CT, and he did a story on Tin House and Floyd Radford. Though I think he called him by a different name in that video, like Floyd Stratford or something. But Floyd Radford with Tin House and his history and how he got involved with Johnny Winter. Though that seemed like a good excuse to drag out related albums and, because, he just showed Steve a couple of albums, the Tin House album and the one Johnny Winter album that I guess he was, Floyd Radford was involved with. So, but I thought I'd do like a family tree related to the Johnny Winter stuff I have. So to start this off with would be going back to 1964 with the McCoys. Hang on, Sloopy. Might be familiar to everybody, but this was, if I say 64, this is 1965. Album on Bang label. So there's Bang, 1965, McCoys. This was Rick and Randy Derringer, Randy Joe Hobbs, and I forget the drummer's name, maybe Peterson, but I think they're going by the name Zeringer at that point. We'll find out. And then another album, follow-up, 1965. You Make Me Feel So Good, The McCoys. This first album, all covers. They didn't weren't doing any writing of themselves. There's a James Brown song, a Bob Dylan song, Call It Stormy Monday, a classic blues song, some other things. And this one, still on the Bang label, 1965, and they do a Beatles song on here, Drive My Car. And they write one song themselves. The end of side one, Mr. Summer. So, classic pop rock on those two albums. Then they started to get a little more progressive or inventive. Infinite McCoys. This is 1968, I think. And they had switched to Mercury. And they had a horn section on here, they had a string section. They're still going by the Zeringer name. The first two albums, they didn't even really give credits for the band. Here, at least they say who's playing on it. Rick and Randy Zeringer, Robert Peterson on piano, Randy Hobbs on bass. Oh, Randy's the drummer, sorry. Infinite McCoys, 1968. And their follow-up was Human Ball. Can see the artwork is getting a little more psychedelic. Here they write majority of the songs. They redo Stormy Monday Blues, T-Bone Walker, which was on their first album. Still on the Mercury label. Then 1974, Jerry LaCroix comes into play. He had an album, The Second Coming. It has Ralph Schuchat, who played with Todd Rundgren on here. Rick Derringer is on a song. Edgar Winter's on a song. So you see there's some involvement. Jerry LaCroix, Second Coming. And that'll get tied back in a moment. Then, what started this whole video? Tin House, 1970. Floyd Radford on guitar, Jerry Cole bass, Mike Logan on drums. So this is on Epic label. This has some stickers. I bought this in Memphis, Tennessee at Poplar Music. Poplar, yeah. Back in the 70s. And then 1976, Glass Derringer. So this is the Derringers with Rick Glass, Dick Glass on guitar, and most of the rest of the McCoys supporting him on this album, which is on LA International Records. Nineteen 76. And then 1972, Edgar Winter's road work with White Trash. And you see Jerry LaCroix is on vocals, Rick Derringer's and Johnny Winter are guesting on guitars. This is 72, so you can see why in 74, when Jerry LaCroix had his solo album, he had several guests on it. And this is a 2 LP gatefold. Epic. So, sort of a white soul rock LP. And then the follow-up, Edgar Winter, They Only Come Out at Night. Put the big hit Frankenstein on here. This is Gatefold. Ronnie Montrose on guitar, Dan Hartman on bass, I think. Edgar Winter. And then the last one before we get into Johnny Winter himself, DNA. This is Rick Derringer and Carmen Appice. Or as Rick at Flipside CT, Carmen Appice. So I'm not sure which is right. I called him Carmen of Peace originally, and then I heard somebody else say it was Apathy, and now I've heard it both ways, so I'm not sure. This is 1983. The rest of the band is Duane Hitchings and Jimmy Johnson. So this sort of sounds like a Cactus with Rick Derringer substituting on guitar, even though it's a few years later than Cactus. This is on Boardwalk label. And then parallel to all those albums, Johnny Winter started putting albums out. So first one I have is Progressive Blues Experiment. This is on Imperial, which I think this is a reissue of the album was initially put out on Sonobeat. There's the Imperial label, and this is one of his best albums, in my opinion. Very blues rocky. Johnny Winter, Before the Storm. This is a 1973 edition of this album, which I think is around the same time as Progressive Blues Experiment. It's a 2 LP set on Janus label. And then Johnny Winter, self-titled on Columbia. More blues rock. Three piece for the most part. Johnny on lead, John Turner on percussion, and Tommy Shannon on bass. The Johnny Winter story. I think this is a compilation. Gatefold. No, this is on GRT. Second winner. This is two LPs with three sides of music on CBS. So a three piece with Edgar Winter rounding it out to number four. So there's just a blank side. There's side three. Johnny Winter changes bands. He's got a majority of McCoys backing him up. Johnny Winter and. So now the Zehringers are the Derringers. So Rick and Randy are supporting him. Of course, Randy's going by Randy Z rather than Randy Derringer. And Rick's Rick Derringer and then Randy Joe Hobbs on bass, still on CBS. Johnny Winter and Live. Good morning, little schoolgirl. Jumpin' Jack Flash. Great Balls of Fire. Long Tall Sally. Johnny B. Good. Randy Z has left and Bobby Caldwell has joined the band. Bobby Caldwell, we've seen in some other bands. Maybe it was Captain Beyond. Johnny Winter still alive and well. I think this was this is 1973. So now it's down to a three-piece. Another Stone song on here, Silver Train. Too Much Second All, Cheap Tequila, All Tore Down. You know, sounds like a blueprint for what ZZ Top would be doing. Still on CBS. And Johnny Winter, Saints and Sinners, 1974. See, that back cover looks quite a lot like Spirit, The 12 Dreams of Dr. Sardonicus, which was, I think, 1972. But Stray Cat Blues, another Stones song. Ride in Cell Block Number 9, Boney Maroney. Just good rock and roll songs. And John Dawson Winter the Third, 1974. Still a three-piece with Randy Joe Hobbs and Richard Hughes. And Johnny Winter captured live, 1976. So now he's got Floyd Radford on second lead guitar. Formerly of Tin House from several years ago. And this is on, oops, Blue Sky. But other than that, the band is the same. Randy Joe Hobbs and Richard Hughes. But they've added Floyd Radford as the fourth on. So I have two lead guitars. And then 77. He's dumped the band and they got a whole new backing crew. This one even has Muddy Waters on vocals, James Cotton on harp, Pine Top Perkins. Nothing but the blues. Blue Sky. White Hot and Blue. Back on CBS, 1978. A lot of the band has changed again. Raising Cane. Blue Sky, which looks like a CBS subsidiary. Guitar Slinger. Another set of band members, 1984. Serious Business. Now he's on Alligator. But same band as the previous records. And then Third Degree, 87, I think, 86. Same band, still on Alligator. And then the last one I've got in this series, the winner of 88. Some reason has this big sticker stuck right on the album. This is on Alligator. I mean on MCA. And got a new band. Back to a three-piece, guitar, bass, and drums. And he went on to do several other ones after this, you know, teamed up with some blues legends on several of them. But this is the last one I've got on vinyl. So that was my Johnny Winter family tree. So thanks, everybody. And I've had this other one sitting here waiting to be filmed for a while, but I don't know when I'll get around to it. That one just jumped up to the top of the pile. So thanks to Steve at Flipside CT for inspiring this video. See you later.